Hi, this is Kathy with Level Up RN. In this episode of Ask a Nurse, I'll be answering your questions about mononucleosis, or mono, such as what causes mononucleosis, what are the symptoms of mononucleosis, and how is mononucleosis diagnosed and treated? Mononucleosis is a viral infection caused by the Epstein-Barr virus. Most people will become infected with this virus at some point in their life, but will not develop symptoms. For those who do develop symptoms, it typically occurs between the ages of 15 and 24. Mononucleosis is sometimes referred to as the kissing disease because it is primarily spread through contaminated saliva. In addition to being spread through kissing, this virus can also be spread through coughing and sneezing, sharing drinks or food, or sharing a toothbrush. And it can be spread through sexual contact as well. Primary symptoms of mononucleosis include fever, sore throat, fatigue, and swollen lymph nodes. Other symptoms may include headache, lack of appetite, a skin rash, muscle aches, as well as an enlarged spleen. Mononucleosis has a long incubation period, and symptoms of mono will not show up for 3 to 6 weeks after exposure to this virus. Mononucleosis is typically diagnosed based on your symptoms and a physical examination by your provider. A monospot blood test may be ordered, which tests for antibodies to the Epstein-Barr virus. If you are in the early stages of the infection, then the results of this test may come back as falsely negative, and you may be asked to repeat this test again in a couple weeks. There is no specific medication that cures mononucleosis. Treatment includes rest, fluids, and over-the-counter medications such as acetaminophen and ibuprofen to help with the fever and pain. Of note, kids and teens should not take aspirin because it carries the risk for a life-threatening disorder called Reye's syndrome. In addition, it is important that athletes avoid physical activity for at least 4 to 6 weeks because mononucleosis causes spleen enlargement, which places the individual at risk for spleen rupture. Most people recover from mononucleosis in about 2 to 4 weeks, but fatigue and weakness may persist for several months. After a mononucleosis infection, the Epstein-Barr virus becomes inactive but remains in your body for life. Sometimes the virus can become reactivated, such as during times of stress. Some people may not have any symptoms with reactivation of the virus, but individuals with a weakened immune system are more likely to experience symptoms. Okay, that is it for this episode of Ask a Nurse. I hope you have found it to be helpful. If so, be sure to hit that like button. And if you have a health topic or question you would like me to address in a future episode, then definitely leave that in the comments. Stay informed and stay well.